Hi guys, welcome to episode 15 of Fresh Takes and Mistakes. I'm Susan, and this is a brand new vlog where we're gonna discuss weight loss, fitness, and all the messy mind stuff in between. I wanna take a moment first to thank all of my loyal viewers, everybody that's been watching me from the beginning, and tell you how crazy it is to me that we are on episode 15. Despite the long break that I took in between when I moved, this is insane. I can't believe how far we've come. I just wanna thank you guys so much for sticking with me and continuing to watch these videos. Today, I wanna talk a little bit about something that really has a lot more to do with weight loss than anything else, but really, I guess, if you're trying to avoid or quit any self-destructive habit. So for me, that was overeating. And today I'm gonna talk about ways to avoid that. And today, specifically, we're gonna talk about hobbies and passions as a way to avoid overeating. So I feel like a lot of you will be able to identify with this. A lot of the time, the problem with overeating is that we're bored. We're sitting around the house, we don't have anything to do. Some of us are moms, some of us are parents, some of us are dads, some of us are whatever the case may be, and all we have to do, the only excitement or thing that we can fill our time with is eating, especially if we're sitting in front of the TV at night and we're trying to fill that time. So what better way to avoid overeating out of boredom than finding your passion? So for me, that kind of kills two birds with one stone, right? So number one, you are not overeating and you're avoiding the self-destructive behavior. For some of you, that might even be smoking or drinking or whatever the case may be. If you have a self-destructive behavior other than overeating, what better way to avoid that self-destructive behavior than to fill it with a constructive behavior like finding your passion or your hobby? How many of you loved to write poetry in high school or paint? How many of you could talk for days and forget to eat or forget to sleep or forget that you're tired? That's me. I'm the kind of person who can talk for hours and forget that I'm hungry. I remember I started one of those multi-level marketing businesses last year where I could go do a party for that business and I would forget to eat entirely by the time I got home. It's 8 o'clock at night. I eat something quick and go to bed, quick and healthy, of course, because I'm trying to lose weight, and I didn't even miss it. I didn't even miss overeating or sitting on my couch eating chips or ice cream or whatever for hours at a time. I didn't even miss it because I spent hours talking to people because that's what I love to do. That's my passion. I love to talk to people. I love to socialize. I love having friends or people that I can just kind of go back and forth with, or even, you know, talk about something deep like philosophy or, you know, society or whatever the case may be. That's my passion. So for you, that passion might be painting, or it might be spirituality. It might be religion. It might be writing. It might be reading, whatever the case may be. Learning, reading is learning. Whatever that case may be, I encourage you to find that passion. So like I said, that for me currently is talking. I'm actually taking a class right now for life coaching, which is something I do want to talk to you guys a little bit about at some point soon. I won't be finished that class for a couple months, but that will be something that I'm starting. And if anybody is interested, I will be specializing in fitness and weight loss, something that I have a little bit of experience with. As you guys know, I've lost 100 pounds, but that just goes into my passion. That's something that I'm passionate about, something that I love doing. And for me, that helps me to stay on my fitness goal and stay on my weight loss goal. And it's something that I can do that I actually forget to do the self-destructive behavior until my body tells me that I'm hungry, I'm not eating. Until my body tells me that I'm tired, I'm not sleeping, I'm not sitting around, I'm not laying around. Because I'm doing something that I'm passionate about, I'm doing something that I love. So I challenge you to sit down and really think about the things that you do in your life, whether it be years ago or whether it be now or whether it be something that you did one time that you loved so much, that you enjoyed so much that you forgot you were hungry or forgot you wanted to smoke or forgot you were tired or had that TV show coming on that you would typically sit around and watch or whatever the case may be. I wanna challenge you to think about that thing and make time for it. Make time for that passion. Make time for that hobby. Make time for that thing, that book you've been meaning to read or that album you've been meaning to listen to, whatever the case may be. Make time for that. That class you've been meaning to take, I did a pottery course a couple weeks ago. I'm telling you, your time really opens up when you realize that you don't need to spend hours on the couch watching TV every night, binging some kind of Netflix show, which don't get me wrong, I love Netflix. It's like the cookie dough thing. Like, it's a great thing to do. You want to have a self-care day, you want to lay around, you want to just relax. I don't have a problem with Netflix. I don't have a problem with Hulu. I don't have a problem with binging any TV shows. It's not a bad thing, but everything in moderation, really. I mean, you hear people say that and you're like, it's a little bit ridiculous. You know, you hear it, everybody say it, and it's kind of a cliche, but it really is true. Everything in moderation. That cookie dough is in moderation. The binging of the TV shows, that's in moderation. Laying around, taking a nap in the middle of the day, in moderation. Drinking, smoking. I mean, I probably wouldn't recommend smoking. It's not really good for you and it's addictive, but whatever. In moderation for the most part is definitely what I recommend. I don't have a problem with Netflix. I don't have a problem with laying around, but if I'm taking a course on pottery or life coaching or painting, a paint night or an escape room or reading a really good book, listening to a good audiobook, having a really good workout, taking a walk with friends and talking for hours about deep stuff or not deep stuff, giving advice to your friends, listening to your friends, you know, their problems and talking through them with them, all those things, they make me forget that I could be eating chips on the couch watching whatever new Netflix TV show I'm watching. You know, and I can save that for Saturday. But it doesn't have to be every day. It's definitely a moderation thing. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about those hobbies and passions today because I think it's so super important to realize, especially when your goal is to quit a self-destructive behavior like overeating or binge eating like I had, you know, you have that thing that you want to do other than overeating. And that can seem a little obsessive when you're talking about, you know, I'm just thinking about when I can get off and eat that cookie dough in my fridge, or I'm just thinking about when I can get off and go to dinner and have that next meal or have that next drink. It really is obsessive, you know, for some people, and it is an addiction for some people. And that was me. I was that person. So I don't want you to feel bad about that. I don't want you to get down on yourself about that, because it is definitely somewhere that I personally have been. I think a lot of you guys have been there. So your fellow viewers, I think, have been there. Don't get down on yourself. In our society, it's very easy, because the way that food is made right now, it is so addictive. It's definitely easy to get into that. And if your self-destructive behavior is smoking or drinking, you know, that's definitely addictive. But I don't want you to get down on yourself about that. What I want you to do is the best thing you can do to stop a self-destructive behavior or to avoid a self-destructive behavior is to just add something else. Just add something you're passionate about. Not something boring, not something you don't want to do, because the minute you don't want to do it, you're going to go ahead and go back to that self-destructive behavior that you would rather be doing. But add something else that you do want to do, something you are passionate about. Like we talked about, talking to people or reading a good book. Writing, painting, whatever your passion is. I want you guys to comment on this page today or on this post today and tell me what your passion is. What is something that you do that makes you forget about eating, makes you forget about sleeping, makes you forget you want that cigarette or you want that glass of wine or whatever the case may be? I want you to comment on this post today and tell me what it is that you do that makes you forget about that, whether that's painting or reading or writing or talking to your friends or going to the gym or a paint night or an escape room or whatever the case is, whatever you enjoy doing, a puzzle that makes you forget about the self-destructive behavior. Comment on here. You can help others. If you comment on here, you might give somebody else an idea. I want to hear what that is. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate you guys. I appreciate you guys who've been watching me from the beginning. If you haven't and this is your first episode, I highly recommend going back, watching the other ones. Not to toot my own horn, but I really, really, really want you guys to benefit in whatever way you can from these videos. That's what I'm here for. So like, comment, tell me what that is that you love to do that makes you forget about the thing that you shouldn't be doing or the self-destructive behavior. I want to hear about it. Subscribe for notifications for your next episode, and I will see you guys next week. Thank you so much.